For regular videos on ancient cultures and forgotten civilizations, please subscribe.
As we previously mentioned, we note the presence of these two numbers that the Egyptians were not supposed to know.
Ah yes, Pi and Phi. Here's the thing about both of them. Egyptian knowledge of Pi and Phi, aka the golden ratio, is not impossible. So even if these are baked into the pyramid somehow, that wouldn't prove anything except that the Egyptians knew their math better than we thought. That's it. And in fact, it would seem the Egyptians did know Pi. A mathematical document known as the Rhind Papyrus shows that the Egyptians were able to calculate the area of a circle by a formula that gave the approximate value of 3.1605 for pi. Not perfect, but they did know of pi. In fact, the Babylonians before them also calculated the area of circles and came up with a value of 3.125 for pi. But it's also possible that the value of pi can be found in the Great Pyramid not by intention, but simply as a byproduct of the construction. If they built the pyramid so that the area of each face would equal the area of a square, the height of which was the height of the pyramid, the base would automatically come out to pi. And Herodotus tells us that the Egyptians told him that is exactly what they did. As for phi, or the golden ratio is, like pi, an irrational number. Its digits go on infinitely. 1.6180339, and on it goes. If someone does a calculation and the number comes out to close to that number, you can say it approximates the golden ratio, but if it's a finite number, it's not truly the golden ratio. And because none of our measurements are even precise for the Great Pyramid, you can only have an approximate number. Whether it's the actual golden ratio or just a regular number, you can't know.